Hello, and welcome to another episode. In this episode, we're going to discuss astronomy magazines, such as these. One of the most popular in the UK is The Sky at Night, and this is full of information on astronomy, as you'd imagine. But it is it does tend to focus now a lot more, now Patrick Moore's passed away, on the more professional side of astronomy. And it's moving away from its kind of amateur roots. And so this video is discussing a magazine maybe could replace that, maybe better for the amateur astronomer. But the number one I also pick up now and again is the Sky and Telescope magazine, which I find much better, a lot less full of adverts. So, after a lot of searching, I came across the Society for Popular Astronomy. It comes out with a bi-monthly magazine, which is written by amateur astronomers, for the most part, for amateur astronomers. And it seems to be, just like what I was looking for. And I thought I'd tell everyone about it and what you get by joining the Society. Well, here's the welcome pack that you get from Popular Astronomy. I was initially quite dubious about it because I've been in astronomical societies before, and I'm used to going to regular meetings and having observing sessions. And this is a national society that also serves Europe and worldwide. And so it seemed quite strange to me not to go to regular meetings, except for I think it's one they have every 3 months in London and some others dotted around the country, as well as the biannual conference. But I thought with the lockdown going on and the amount I spend on astronomy magazines anyway, seemed like a very good deal. This is £23 a year, and you get a magazine every 2 months. Compare that to the price of most astronomy magazines, and it's actually pretty good. And I think you get a bit more with the society stuff. So this is one of the things you get in the pack. So I'm starting out with the society, and details everything about the society, how they can help you, the different sections of it, the meetings they do online, kind of getting together and asking for advice on things like GCSE astronomy or astro imaging and general observing, as well as the sections of the different sections of the society they have, such as comet observing, lunar observing, meteor observing, and so on. And you can get involved with these different sections, send in your observations. And it's also got some quite nice advice on doing some getting started in astronomy for the different parts, times of the year, which is actually quite nice ideas they've got in here. So for the summer triangle and the winter triangle, it's really quite nice. Finishes with the rules of the society. This is just another little leaflet they have in here, mainly about getting started in astronomy, some little tips, and how the society can help you as you move deeper into the hobby. But this is probably what most of you are interested in. It's the magazine. It's really quite nice. The cover is actually quite thick, quite hard there. It's full colour, which is good. And it really focuses on the kind of amateur side of everything and how you can get involved. And it's, that's a whole section there on citizen science and explaining various different things within astronomy. I do find that the Sky at Night magazine is now it's being kind of taken over by PhD astronomers and stuff. It focuses a lot on cutting edge astronomy, which is great. You know, it's good to have all that kind of stuff, but I think there is kind of too much of a focus on that. And not so much what you as an amateur astronomer can do, which is, I feel when I come away from reading a Sky at Night magazine, then it's not really inspire me, which I think is important if you're gonna buy a magazine for your hobby. And reading this, I thought it was absolutely fantastic. I mean, Patrick Moore used to regularly talk about sketching various different things, sketching the moon, sketching planets, and so on. And I really
haven't heard much, read much rather, in the Skylight magazines about that kind of thing, but this is something that an amateur can really do well, and it's got 3 pages on that. It's absolutely fantastic. Also, I noticed that there's a lot less adverts in that. There's a few. The inside front and back cover have adverts on. But other than that, there's only just the odd page. Where I find a lot of the Skylight magazines actually advert. And again, like another section on something like what a amateur can do, astrophotography. It does have some cutting edge science. That's what you want. That you do want to see what's going on in space exploration, and it has it. I noticed actually that one of the articles in here seemed to be almost verbatim as there is in Sky Night magazine. So I guess they've got the same author there. It's got stuff for the younger astronomer, conversations with astronauts, more space exploration things, as well as observing tips and what's coming up. And I'm sure as you do, I look online, and I like to see what the magazine is saying, the highlights to see, and they do have that. And I mentioned before about the sections of the society. Well, the sections get a section in the magazine, and you've got stuff on here on auroras, comets, and these are what people are contributing to these sections of the society. And what they're finding interesting, and you find it very inspiring to see what people are up to. And again, you can tell this is written for amateurs. There's actually drawings in here, as well as, photos people have taken. It does feel like a proper, proper kind of amateur magazine, which is what we all are, really. So it's good to have that. And it has got some book reviews, and like you'll usually find in an astronomy magazine, what's the latest book to read. And this I thought was great. I mean, it's got like the Sky Diary. So it's a lot of dense detail. There's a lot of detail that you just don't seem to get. It seems to gloss it a bit in the Skylight magazine. There's a lot of detail here. I'm very impressed. And it feels like a very solid magazine. I'm surprised at the price it is. It's very good. So I'm going to stick with the Popular Astronomy Society, I think, and stop buying the other magazines and just read this, because I found it a lot more inspiring. And if you give it a go, I'm sure you will do too.
Well, I hope you found that interesting and perhaps inspired you to give the Society for Popular Astronomy a go. If you've got any questions, please ask them below in the comments. If you like this video, give it a like. And please subscribe for more astronomy videos. Goodbye and clear skies.